Hello everyone, my name is Karazar, and welcome back to Vintage Story Desert Life, Episode 17. This video originally broadcast live on YouTube on May 4th, 2024. Enjoy the video. Welcome, Gandalf the Magenta. My granddaughter wants me to tell you that she likes you. Thank you. Hello everybody. Welcome to Vintage Story Desert Life. My name is Karazar, if you couldn't guess by the name tag over my head. And welcome to everybody in chat. Welcome to the stream, everybody. We have a big day ahead of us. And I had a request to go over the checklist for today before we start. And I guess let's go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and get in here. So the checklist today is I want to go over the stream results from the panning. So we have that here. A very quick and apparently glitchy opening and closing of those there. Thank you for that. Game. We have a finished leather over here, so we're going to make some backpacks and then push some leather production along. And then we have a few like minor chores. I want to go and harvest and replant the farms. And then the majority of today, I want to take a look and pay attention to our house here. The house that will be here. This is not currently a house by any stretch of the imagination. But as you'll recall, last time we streamed, well, at least not on Wednesday, the last full stream, we got a whole bunch of sandstone rock, and I think we're going to build most of our house out of sandstone, probably with some accents of acacia, and I might also go and knock down a couple of the ebony trees. I think there are a couple over to the west, over that direction, way, way over there. And of course, we have a sandstorm going on, because why wouldn't it be? All right, so starting with the previous stream, we got a lot done. We got everything here panned, so we got 3 aged lore books. I'm not going to add them to the journal immediately. I might kind of save these for another kind of like off schedule stream, at least for reading. We got a rough diamond, some uranium, some silver, some phosphorite, some corundum, some native gold, a couple copper arrowheads, some bunny rib cages. A decent amount of flax fibers, a whole ton of bones, a bronze armlet, which I think we can go ahead and wear. I don't think we have anything on our arm there. There we go. Perfect. We got 5 rusty gears, some fluorite, some flint arrowheads, a couple copper spearheads, a rough peridot, 1 piece of kernite, 1 rough emerald, and 2 candles. Now, our bees are mostly ready to harvest at this point, so the candles aren't quite as vital, but it's nice to have a couple extras. Am I a storm instigator? Yes, I am. Let's see, who else is here now? We have Don Gubb and Ben Ben and BW. Welcome to the chat and welcome to the channel. So, we also, in addition to the panning, we took down a whole lot of trees over here. As you can see, the desert in this direction is pretty bald at the moment. And we got a good number of sticks for doing pit kilns and ladders and all manner of stuff. And we got some wood from that. A lot of that wood has already gone into another charcoal pit, which is over here, and looks like it's about done. Yeah, we're not smoking anymore. Yeah, all right. To dig that out here real soon. In addition to that, we also burned through our copper scythe, and we made a new bronze scythe, and we got a bunch of grass, again, for pit kiln work. And welcome to Nixaromaticon. Thank you for coming to the stream. So let's see, we got the chores stream review is over. Let's get on with the basic chores to do this stream. I want to dig out this charcoal pit here and add it to our stockpile. And then we are finally going to upgrade or start upgrading to leather backpacks. We've been using these hunter's packs for a while. Now, we don't have a ton of leather. I think we have enough for maybe 2 or 3 backpacks. But I'd also like to keep at least a couple pieces of leather around so we can make some better bows when and if our recurve bow stays finish drying. So if we only have like 24 or so leather, then I'm going to just keep a couple and we'll just make 2 backpacks. That will still be a 20% increase in storage space for us. Or inventory space. And is this a waste of a bronze shovel? Maybe. But on a stream, better than using stone or your hands. Okay. Oh, also, sort of a stretch goal for today, which I don't know we'll get to, because I do want to focus on the living quarters, is that we could keep going on the wall. That's sort of like, if we finish up most of our home here, and I have some stone left over, I want to get at least a 2-block-tall wall going on, just so that when drifters come a-knocking, then they can't knock. Well, they can knock all they want. They can't get in. If I close the doors. That's a big if. Let's see. Okay, we are good on charcoal for a while. That's excellent. And I'm going to tuck this knife blade somewhere else, like here. And oh, we are very full on grass. I'm also going to pull over the flax fibers we got and combine them with the ones we have here and turn at least some of these into twine. Maybe even on, well, all of them, I guess. There really isn't a reason not to. So we have 16. That's enough for 4 pieces of linen. I'm not going to make linen bags because we are already so far along on leather working. So we have 16 leather. Ooh. Ooh, that's a tough one. Because it takes 8 leather to make 1 backpack. Now we do have a couple prepared hides in here we can dump in here and get a few more leather after 5 days. Where are our bow staves? Here they are. It is dry. Oh. Oh. I'm definitely thinking. I'm going to pop 1 backpack in here. And then I think we'll just move these guys over here. Continue our leather working progress. Turn to 6 leather. That's not worth it. 6 leather. Oh, get out of here. Do we have anything else we can push along here? You're empty. I had a box around here. I'm very organized. Very, very organized. I had a box around here with some extra hides in here. Here we go. Oh, these are pelts. Maybe I'm lying to you guys and myself. yeah, okay, maybe we don't have any leather left to process. I could have sworn we did. Oh, right, they're here. I'm walking on them. This is why I didn't want to put them on the ground. Okay, so we need to not throw them on the ground. Prepared hide is going to be 10 liters. Okay. We have 6. I might make a couple more barrels or even repurpose some of these guys and start a fresh batch of this stuff here. Alright, so we are going to go ahead and we're going to throw these 2 in here. It's a bit of a waste of time. 6 leather isn't great, but at least it'll let us use 1 backpack for now. We'll turn 2 of these into bows. We'll have to go and kill a hyena or something. And then we'll have 6 more leather to make a 2nd backpack plus some change in 4.5 days. That's the plan. So let's tuck the leather in somewhere. We're getting suspiciously low on real storage space. Let's do you. You already have some pelts in you and some rot. I don't think I have any more rot to put in a barrel. All right, so bucket. Let's get a bucket. Let's grab our saw and let's make a few more barrels. There should be plenty. If not overkill. Overkill it is. Okay. There is no kill like overkill. And everyone's favorite part of the game is puddling water to and from barrels. Let's go ahead and get some of that done here. A kingdom for another way of filling barrels. There we go. All right, now, the part that I always forget, and people yell at me, is I always forget you can just use a hammer on your limestone. You don't have to sit here and grind it in the quern. So let's grab some limestones here. Let's get these hammered up. Let's get them hammered. That's different. There we go. So we're gonna hammer these guys down. So it does blow through some hammer durability, but I think it's worth it in this case. So there's that, and there's that. So now we are ready for next time we have at least a few hides, and it may be worth taking a trip out to kill a couple beasts out yonder and bring back some hides to start processing. But let's start getting the tannins going in these two barrels. Seal you. Seal you. And the scraped hide, these will have to wait a little longer. Let's put them down where I forget about them again. Woohoo! There we go. Alright, so we have two dried recurve bow staves. They do stack, that's good. Let's go ahead and find out what we need to make these things. We need bones, twine. We got the twine just now. Bones and raw bushmeat. So the bushmeat is all we're missing right now. Let's go get some. We have three spears. Let's take five because I have such great aim. And it should be hard finding a hyena. They are everywhere in the desert. Of course, I say that. I say that, and they're just going to not be anywhere, right? That's how it works. There's that bunny I was looking for last stream. Gazelles. No, I don't need gazelles. Oh, is this the... Oh, I found it. Here's the one piece of bony soil that I couldn't find last time. There we go. Got it. Oh, man. In the previous stream, the chores stream, I remembered that there was one piece of bony soil somewhere and I couldn't find the ruin where it came from. I think, either Crone 22 or Pam spotted it. We got chickens. Ooh. We have a lot of hyenas gathered together. I don't want to deal with a gaggle of them. Or a murder of them. Whatever they are. They're not crows, I guess. There's a couple over here. Let's take out one of these guys. They are spawning back in with a vengeance, though. Before I do, let's see. Who else is here? We have... Let's see. Hello, Wolf Mistress. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to the stream. Welcome, Sales Tax 1. Joshua Ceruta, welcome. Scorpius, thanks for coming. Welcome, guys. Thanks for coming to the stream. All right, let's take out one of these hyenas. Probably smack the other one just to get him to go away. Hello. Boop. Boop. Oop, that went over your head. Yep, and then we're going to just scare you off, I think. Or, well, you know what? Maybe we'll just take care of you. And, oop. Up. Not quite. Let's get you there. Over your head. I'm still unused to the Bullseye mod. Sometimes, like, it looks really accurate, and then I'm like, I'm a little high, a little low. Usually high. Yeah, I think that white reticle is a lot more accurate than the game's default one, which kind of throws me off. But while it's still charging, it's like the yellow reticle is, like, way low sometimes. All right, so we got a little bit there. Let's bust you up. Get some of those bones. Not that we need any. And we got you. All right, tons of bush meat, which isn't anything I really need. Let's go zap a few more hyenas, although I'm missing my light. I think I left it on the ground next to our tanning station. So I think I'm going to go grab that, and then we'll hunt a few more hyenas. Hello, Nystic Creations. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to the chat. Hello, Gonzalo Arguello. I think I got that right, but maybe I didn't. Arguello? A bite to eat on the run. Who doesn't love running and eating at the same time? It's good for your stomach. It's good for digestion. All right, let's grab you. There we go. Now we have a light. And we discovered last stream that in your hand, the oil lamp is just as bright as the torch, which is goofy. But I don't make the rules. Hey there, Lake Filter. Glad to see you here. All right, where were those darn hyenas? Now there's one pack right there. Oh, there's like four of them. Holy moly. Hello, buddy. I keep backing up as he's walking. Gotcha. All right, there's three more. Wow. Holy moly. All right. Can I get the other one? Oh, wait, it runs off. I cannot. Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought. Oh, look at that. What a shot. I can barely see it in the grass there. Oh, yes. Got you too. So I can strip these guys. Oops. Okay, so track it back this way should be the first one we got. Yep, here we are. Got tons of junky meat here. Gonna be very tasty. Hello there, Just Video Games and Nimu Dulac. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to the stream. Here's another one of these guys. Boop. Oh, that's over. Yep, so that white reticle is very accurate, especially at close to medium range. And it doesn't seem because I'm sneaking, which is a little silly, but I'll take it. There we go. That was one we hadn't hit yet, I think. Because it took three shots. Ah, two hides, finally. There we go. All right, there's one more, but it's probably dispersed into the darkness by now. Oh, here's a couple more, though. Although our spears are getting a little bit low on durability. See if we can zap this guy. Barely hit that one. And... oh, we got him. We are now out of them, though. So let's... got you. Oh, right over her head. Oh, nice. That must have been the one we hit earlier. Oh, dear. Oh, my. Let's not go there. Yikes. Come on. There we go. No fat on you. Just skin and bones. And what have you got for us? Oh, by the way, one of the mods I have on is a handy one that lets you, peer through the grass in order to harvest. So it makes harvesting a little bit less of a pain if you have carcasses amongst the grass and the weeds. All right, ooh, we got another nasty pit here. Boy, I kind of want to break that. You know what? Let's stand somewhere that seems safe enough. Boop. Yeah, that needed to happen. Let's do that over here too. If we stand here, we should be okay. There we go. All right, one less hazard to worry about. Hello, Leffy. Welcome to the stream. Let's get back. Let's push along a little bit more leatherworking. Oh, we've got a bonus bunny. There's two of them now. And then I'll probably sleep through the night just to make it a little brighter so we can actually do some stuff and see what we're doing. Although, now that I think about it, we might just work through the night because it is calm. And for some reason, the meat that I made at the very end of last episode is somehow already down to 1 day of spoil time left. I don't know why it shouldn't be that way, but it is. So, Zadge. Two raw hides. There we go, 11 raw hides. Okay. We're still one short. We're short one raw hide to fill out one of these, but you know what? I'm not going to worry about that too much, I think. I think this is going to be plenty. Where'd you go? There you are. Yeah. 12 would let us round that out. Hey there, Alexander FF. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, we got a brand new leather bag. We have enough to make another one. I have 6 more leather in somewhere. Here we go. But I want to make these recurve bows first. And I'd like to try them out with the Bullseye mod on. I've heard that they're actually not as fast as the longbows, but we don't have any wood for making a longbow. They require a non-tropical hardwood. We can't make them out of acacia or out of kapok. So, yeah. I have fat stored somewhere. And someday, I will get everything organized. Probably in a chores stream. Ah, there you are. We are golden on fat. That could be good fodder for making some more oil lamps, because I think it's going to take us a while to get to get a lot of lanterns going on. So keep that in mind for later. All right, let's get our string and let's make our new bows. So we got string, leather, bones, bushmeat, bow staves. Here we go. That should be everything we need, I think. Yeah. 600 durability and 35% more piercing damage. Now, I wonder if that multiplies with the existing hunter bonus to damage. And as for the rest of this, I think I'm going to let this rot because we need to get our rot production going. So I'm just going to tuck this in here. It's terrible meat anyway and is a waste of fuel. And since we're about to go and harvest... It's raining again, guys. It's raining again in the desert where rain is rare. Oh my goodness. Once again. Oh my goodness. Oh, here we go. A large pelt. All right. I'm just going to stack you with the rest of the large pelts. Boop. There we go. I don't know that we'll have a use for those, except maybe as carpeting. Ooh, it is actually high rotativity all of a sudden. So let's go ahead and sleep after all. I wasn't going to, but here we are. No need to have drifty friends after us. I am the storm instigator, certainly. It never fails. I don't know what the deal is. Let's sleep till it says like 5-ish. There we go. All right. Nice and bright out. It's still high, but we don't care. I do spy some drifties. Let's grab some more spears and go after them. And by some more, I mean the only other two we have. Hello. What? Jerk. Yeah, I don't like the long charge up time in Bullseye. It's a real pain. It is nice that it charges a bit better while you're running. So I wonder if that's part of the intent, is like you're supposed to use spears on the run. Because I don't see any difference in accuracy when I miss because I'm a clum. But yeah, I mean, it seems like it stays pretty well charged. and doesn't, like, get jittery. At least, not much. Hi, buddy. I want this one. Boop. There we go. Can we get one more temporal gear today? Let's find out. I doubt it, but there's always a chance. Now she says, yes, running plus throwing is more damage. Interesting. I assume you have to be running toward the target to do that. And actually hit it, too. Usually helps. Ooh, one flax. All right. What a haul. There we go. Let's chuck these back in here. We do have that piece of bony soil that we don't need clogging up our inventory. We'll finish up the stack of bones here, and then we will wish we had more storage space and a better organized storage space. I'm going to chuck this on the ground. Boop. And, yeah, it is fresh for 4 hours. I made this pot of meat like a day ago, and it said fresh for 5 days. So, shime. And I even put it in our thing down here, and I took a look. It didn't extend the spoil timer very much. So, yeah. Sales tax 1, the targeting reticle was more accurate. Yeah, once it turns white, it gets a lot more accurate. And welcome to Ghostering 8. Glad to see you here. Alright, so we have leather backpacks, we have leather production going, we have the chores review done. It is time to go and harvest and replant our farms here. With this bowl in my face, apparently. As I had noted last time that we did have a pretty full crop of a couple things here. Yep, and our flax is now actually all done, except for this, which was planted later. So we're going to harvest these guys, and we'll swap them with the flax. Now, a bit of a sad thing to note is that previously, up through, I think, version 1.18, got a hole here that rabbits could swim up through. You were able to... That's ugly, too. There we go. You were able to get a full harvest of the flax fibers, even if they were heat or cold damaged. And I believe that's been changed now. Our onions are a couple days away. Our peanuts are a couple days away. So let's see. I'm going to guess we're not going to get much string. Oh, we got 5. I think that's about half, I'm pretty sure. 5, 10... We're getting 5 per. I do think that's a bit less. I want to say you can get like 8 to 10 normally. But not a bad haul for being heat damaged. All right. So let's get our seeds in place here. We've got 11 new flax seeds. So let's just drop them in here. K is good all along here. Wow. I think we have a couple more we could plant. And I think I will do that. Let's go ahead and get these seeds in. Some N crops. There we go. And here, I think I'll go ahead and do N's because we're going to roll over these K crops relatively soon. So we'll just do that. And we'll get one more flax seed to plant right here. And our pineapple, our lone pineapple. But it does look like we'll have some vegetables soon. Yeah. We're eating meat and grains. Hello, Gerard. Welcome to the stream. Glad to see you here. So we got a good amount of grains from all that. It's always good to see. And we got some junk grain we can feed to our chickens, finally. That's perfect. And so we need, what, one flax seed. I'll just bring the whole stack. I think I have some more... I have some sunflower. Here we go, amaranth. Okay, so anything in that sort of extra N area is going to get some N. Get these off our bar. There we go. So flax goes there, and I think we had, yep, one more spot for an end crop right there. These are still a few days away, but that's okay. We now have every crop lot filled. Perfect. Ignoring the fences that are on the outside of that area. That's okay. Indy says, your daughter just walked by. The pineapple stands alone. That's pretty good. All right, got some more twine, or fibers turned into twine. Let's go ahead and do that. 12. Not bad. Not a ton, but not bad. Oh, and hey, our trees grew. More trees grew. That's excellent. 2 days for this one. This is turning into a nice little oasis. And I had a thought. I mean, this is going to be an oasis, right? We will need a place here for a kind of like, you know, a pool or a little pond. I'm thinking just right here, like right in the middle. It's a perfect spot for it once we get all this stuff moved out of here. All right, let's go feed our chickens. Again, I'm out the wrong gate, always. And hello, chickalicks. We have like, what? We have two of you in there, I think. No, don't eat it. There we go. Perfect. I will be sad to not be able to jump over the wall, but I won't be sad to have drifters not being able to jump over the wall. And let's go ahead and we'll just tuck these down here too. Boop. All right. That brings us to kind of the last long set of checkboxes I have here, which are all related to building our home. And I think I'm going to focus on this area here today. This is going to be our actual home where we live. Over here, I mentioned that this is where I want to put the chicken coop at some point. And I think this will come a little bit later. This might happen in the next stream, maybe the one after. I might wait until we get like at least one live generation of chicks over yonder. There they are. And then we'll sort of just corral the whole family into here. Let's drop. Oh, wait. Did I lose a bow? I did not lose a bow. Okay, good. You know what? Yeah, hello. Before we actually do that, I do want to see... You don't have any arrows. Really. All right. I think I want to try out these arrows first. Let's just use a couple of these flint ones. And I think I won't make good arrows, because making good flint arrows with feathers is kind of pointless. Just make 5. I want to see how this feels to use. Oh, I don't like that at all. Oh, I don't like that at all. Ugh. Ugh. Okay. I know there's a setting where you can change it so that it goes back to what it was before, where it'll follow your mouse better. I don't like this where it looks around the screen. Oh my, that is a slow draw time. Okay. Well, I've heard tell that the longbow is the speed bow, which is kind of weird to me, given that recurve bows tend to have better handling than a real longbow. So, yeah, a little skeptical on that one. Right, we'll just tuck you in here too. All right, so we can use basket traps to transport the chickens. They have to be hungry. The basket traps are neat. I don't see a purpose to them, given that I can just chase them through a trough to where I want them to go. Like, a basket trap costs reeds and food and time, whereas I can just dig a hole and chase them all in one go. Hello there, Norbix. It's nice to watch something interesting on this boring Saturday. Boring Saturday? You got a whole day ahead of you. Thanks for being here. Yes, sales tax. There's a setting for looking around the screen with the bow. That's the setting I was talking about changing for next time. So, as far as our house here goes, our little home, I want to do a two-story house right here. And I think the first floor is going to mostly be like living space. We will do a basement, so it'll be a third level, effectively. We'll call it a cellar. We'll have a second floor where I probably have, like, our bed and then storage, like mass storage. And then the roof will probably be where we put our leather making and stuff, all the barrels of smelly things go up on the roof. Down here, I think I'm going to probably plant one more acacia tree, probably like right on this corner or something eventually. But I want to wait to see like how we end up finishing this area. And I might extend this area a little bit. But down here, I want to have a forge area. And the forge is actually going to be at ground level. So it'll be walk-in right here. We'll have a little porch up here, I think, or maybe just a step up into the house. And then over here, we will have a little like vineyard where we'll plant some berry bushes. Although, if the berry bushes don't flower and produce berries in winter, once that comes around, then I'll probably trade them out for like one or two fruit trees next year. But we will see how that goes. And as long as these few produce some berries in the winter, then I'll go and get some more bushes and we'll fill them out. We could even fill them out just before then. So we got the sand. It's going to go back in the sand bin. Boop. And we have already some sandstone blocks and rocks and things. And do we have anything in the limestone department? We do not. Okay. Whoops. Goodbye. Goodbye, shovel. So let's see here. I think let's start. I'm going to do probably a bit more cobblestone at the base. And then I think because this building, I think I'm going to say this building is newer than the rest of the area. I think we'll sort of progress up to probably smooth sandstone here and there. And I'll probably just chisel my own stairs. Thank you very much. As far as the age polished goes, I think we'll leave that. Let's make some more cobblestone. And some of that will be able to go toward more wall too. There we go. And I have never really built with people watching. I usually have a lot of time to hem and haw. So I'm gonna see what I can do. I don't have mortar for bricks. Well, we can do that real quick. It's a duck. Let's do more hammering on this limestone. Down into lime. So we can tuck you there. And we are going to have to burn through some of our coal here. But we have the better fire pit mod on, so it should be a lot more efficient than it used to be. Let's start with like 10. 10 might be overkill, I don't know. And while we're lighting this up, welcome to Signicia X1 and Crackhead Tom. And Diggity Y, Zelbriggan, welcome to the stream. And Patrick Acock, welcome to you too. Diggity's asking, how do you not give up on your worlds? You have 3 worlds of 50 hours of play and it's become boring. I don't have a great answer for you because I don't know what your creative process is like. I really enjoy building, so that can stretch a game's duration out to a very long while. Okay, so let's see how long this is going to be here. Are you... Yeah, 10 might do it. 10 might do it. Cross our fingers. Let's go ahead and we're going to get some walls in here. Starting with, like I said, some cobblestone at the base. So let's just start that here. I think our doorway out is probably going to be, yeah, right here. That will give us a little bit like a corner table we could put in there. So then I can maybe... Oh, this takes forever to break by hand now. I forgot. Let's grab our pickaxe. Wherever it might be hiding. There you are. Do we really only have one? Wow. Okay, I guess we do. That shouldn't be a problem for today's endeavor, though. Okay, and we're going to get... Bye. Bye. Get some of this going on here, too. And I might actually bring this out one more block to here, just to give us a bit more room inside. And we will have an exit right there. So something a bit like this, and then we'll just do that. I might even, if we have enough, I have 18 of these aged polished rocks. I might even turn these into the aged polished stuff, just to give our doorways a bit more definition. Or I could just use regular polish. Let's take a look at each of these and see the merits of both. So we have this. So there's that. And then we have... It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we won't have enough for all of these with just this. We might have to go and ransack another ruin. Let's see what we got here. Nope. Don't stand too close. So that, or that, I like this better. I like having a nice bright entrance. I might even raise it up one and like have a door, or maybe even, yeah, I think for practical purposes, we'll have to have a door just to keep drifters out and so they can't throw stones at us. But then I could raise this up by a block and have like a nice open airway above, maybe even chisel a little like vault into it. But yeah, this is great for, I think, like places that are old and grimy and or dirty, like a floor. But I think for a doorway, I want the nice polished stuff. There we go. And I'm going to go and grab... Let's see, we have these guys. The finishing chisel. All right, so rough cut gives us regular stone. Finishing gives us polished stone, and we want a few of those. So let's do something a bit like this. We're going to snag this out of here. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 per... Oh, did it again. You go there. So a bit like that. Should be pretty nice, I think. And we need, let's see, 18 total. So we need 15 more. Let's go ahead and we need a hammer in our offhand, as I recall. Do I have the hammer anymore? No, I don't. Boop. And I think we already used up the small blocks. Let's go ahead and just, there we go. I might just turn all of this into polished for now. Just this one pallet right here. Boop. There we go. That gives us plenty of material for our doors. There's that. Then we can bust this one out here. There we go. All right. That's a decent start. I think the second floor... Actually, I think we'll do is we'll probably do a 3.5 block tall ceiling here. And we'll just do a second floor with slabs for the flooring here. And on the topic of those slabs, where's our kapok box? I'm leaning toward kapok for the time being. Acacia is wonderful, but it's very stark. And I want to use it as like an accent color for some things, like doors, maybe window frames, that kind of thing. But for a floor, it's going to get a little bit much. Well, everyone, that's going to about do it for this episode of Vintage Story Desert Life. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, let me know by leaving a like or a comment in the section below. But for now, as always, my new husband Corazar, thank y'all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.